What's up, good people? Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Blue Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know that this literally does not work. It is finally freaking Friday, and the weather is not... This is beautiful. This is literally like the perfect temperature out here. It's not hot, and it's not cold. It's got just like a little chill, just a little bit. You can feel the sun warming up my head, but you still got a little crispness in the air. This literally is perfection, okay? The bugs haven't gotten out from the winter. This is like literally heaven. Only thing that would be better is if the leaves were on the trees for just a little bit of shade. But other than that, it's great. To think that last Friday, it was about 68 degrees, and then we got snow on Saturday, and it was like 12 degrees. A week later, it's 75. It's unreal. In fact, you can see this fish. You can see my babies. It's supposed to stay warm the next couple of days. You know what? I'm going to go ahead. I'm just so happy to see it. You see them circling. I'm just going to throw a couple pieces of food in here and see if they actually come up. Let's see if they do it. They're looking. This will be the first time I've fed them since last October. Oh, look, there they are. Aren't they beautiful? Okay. Woosah. I did a live stream earlier when... And I went off. I went off a little bit. I'm not going to lie. Let me say this much. Van Der Esch re-signed for $3 million. It's kind of like what we did with Sean Lee his last year. He was a veteran presence. He wasn't as valuable as he used to be, but still a guy who understands the system and is not a bad player. At $3 million, I'm not, you know, that's not the be-all, end-all. That's not the problem. The question is that all we're going to do? Are we just going to look at the draft and say, we'll just go ahead and, roll the dice and try and get another linebacker to go with Van Der Esch, but pencil him in as a starter? Isn't it nice to see them? We'll see what else is going to transpire. This is just a minor move. This actually is more of exactly what Stephen Jones says. Stephen Jones says, we believe in our own free agents because we know what we're going to get. Yes, we do. We know exactly what we're going to get. And you believe in them, and we're bringing them back. So we basically are doing what Tampa Bay did last year. Tampa Bay said, we won the Super Bowl. We're going to run it back with the same team. The only problem is we didn't win the Super Bowl. We didn't have enough to win the Super Bowl. So we'll see if they supplement him with other players. Now, here's the real question for you. My real big question is this. Because we're running this back, Michael Gallop on basically the Amari Cooper type situation, where it's basically a two-year deal, is not a bad deal. It's not a bad deal for the player per se. But here's the problem. What if Amari Cooper, who typically... it's anywhere from 6 to 10 months on an ACL recovery. If it's 6 months, then that's like right in the middle of training camp. If it's more like the 8 months or the 10 months, then we're talking about possibly like October or November and half of the season going by. Michael Gallup is not a bad receiver on the outside. Okay, he does have some drops and things from time to time. He's not a bad receiver. But what if, and I think you always have to plan for worst case scenario. I always say, hope for the best and expect the worst and you'll never be disappointed. What if Michael Gallup is not ready to start the season? Right? You've already lost Amari Cooper. You've got CD and you have Noah Brown. Is that going to be enough to start the season? Is there a backup plan if he's not ready? Because I don't know what it is. Even if you say, we're going to draft a receiver, probably the first round, because that's what the Cowboys, that's what we do. We have other problems on the team, and the thing that we do is we go for the sizzle as opposed to the substance. For me, I'd rather see us go ahead and get a defensive lineman, an offensive lineman, and be in positions to build from the line out. But now, because of possibility of Michael Gallop not being ready, you're probably going to have to take a receiver in the first two rounds. Maybe I'm wrong. But to me, if Michael Gallup's not ready, you can't go in the season with Dalton Schultz and Micah Parsons. Oh, my God. This screwed me all up. And maybe it is. Maybe the plan is Micah Parsons is going to play some offense. But, CeeDee Lamb and Dalton Schultz is really the only targets that you have that are anywhere near reliable to start the season. You know that the Cowboys will start the season with a prime game against somebody big. We started, of course, with Tampa Bay. Do you think we're going to start with the Giants now because the Cowboys will be starting? No. They're going to want to see us in prime time in a big matchup to start the season. That's just the way it is. And so, if he is not ready, what is the plan? That's the bottom line. What is the plan if Michael Gallup is not ready? And you have to look at this and say, worst case scenario, he's not going to be ready. So, coach, what are we going to do? I don't know. But it feels like we are feeling like we had good enough players to win a Super Bowl. We can minus a few of those starters, and we'll just be able to plug some people in. I don't think that is a recipe for success. Not when other teams are literally becoming superpower teams. I feel like the Cowboys right now are a rudderless ship. And usually when it's a rudderless ship, instead of having a plan of action, generally what happens is you make moves to appear like we are doing something. You follow me? Right now, I don't know that Stephen Jones could get much worse publicity. I don't know that the fan base could be much lower than they are now. And so as you start being out there, you start grasping for straws to try and do something to change the narrative. And that's usually when you make a mistake. Signing Michael Gallup on a team-friendly deal? Okay, I got you. That's good. Signing back, Van Der Esch for chump change? Okay, those are cool things. And those are good things if you're supplementing, doing those things to supplement other good moves. But if those are the only moves that you are making, then we're in trouble. We're truly in trouble. Oh, there's Mike. Hey, Money Mike. Roscoe! Mike's out walking Roscoe. I've had a hard time going for walks because when we would go for walks, it was me, Roscoe, Simba, and of course the wife. And we actually haven't been on a walk since Simba passed. We got to move on. But at least I can see my babies here. At least they made it through the winter. And in a couple days, it'll actually be the first day of spring. So, we'll see. There's still some good free agents out there. Maybe the Cowboys. Maybe it's just that Stephen Jones refuses to sign a free agent from another team the first week. Maybe come Monday or Sunday, because it's a new week, maybe they'll sign Bobby Wagner. I don't know. But I'm not going to hold my breath. I'm going to clean out some leaves here and do some work on the pond while the weather's nice. But other than that, it's going to be an interesting spring, y'all. Peace.